Hello friends, today I would like to discuss the concept of praise. Now let us see what we mean by praise. Already we had the reference in the earlier lecture. The sentences are formed of words, but before these words become a sentence, they are first grouped into meaningful groups. They are called phrases. Whenever we have the words, when we combine the words together at that time, that becomes a phrase. So sentences are formed of words, but before these words become a sentence, they are first grouped into meaningful groups that are called phrases. Means whenever we frame any one kind of the grammatical sentence, at that time there are some words. Before that, before framing the structure of any sentence, there are also some group of words are there. What are the group of words, combination of words? They are called phrases. Here, what are phrases made up of? You might have a question in your mind. What are phrases made up of? What kind of phrase do we generally have in languages? What kind of phrases do we generally have in languages? Now, these are the questions when we have in mind. Then immediately we have the answer like this. The phrases are made up of a group of words that come together to modify the meaning of a head word. When we have the combination of words, that group of words that come together in order to modify the meaning of a head of word. So the phrases are made up of a group of words which modify the meaning of a head of word. In linguistics, we use the term modify to mean add something to the meaning. In linguistics, we use the term modify. Why we use the term modify? In order to add something to the meaning or to make the meaning of a word more specific. For that purpose, we use the term modify in order to make the word more specific or to make the meaning specific, to add something. So we add something in order to have the more specific meaning. In order to give an example of what do you mean by modification, here we have to see the example. What do you mean by the modification? Here, let us see the example. Then it will clear that what do you mean by the modification. Let us take one example of a word, a shirt. Shirt is a noun. But if we add an adjective before this noun to take it as green shirt. See here, you know how way there is a modification. Here one word is shirt only, which is a noun. But when we add something before that word, that is adjective, it becomes green shirt. If we add an adjective before this noun to make it, it becomes green shirt. We say that green modifies the meaning of shirt here. What kind of shirt is here? Which gives the meaning it modifies? It modifies green shirt. So here that green modifies the meaning of the shirt. In this way here, we have the example of the modification. Here we have only one word, that shirt. When we add adjective before it, it modifies the meaning of the word shirt. So of all the millions of possible shirts, that shirt could refer to the addition of the modifier green. Now limits, it limits which shirts could be referred to, that is only green shirt, because there are millions of shirts out there which could refer and to the addition of the modifier. It modifies that green only. That because there is a limits which shirts that could be referred to, that is only the green shirt. In this way, there is a modification of the different kinds of the words. Here is one example of the shirt, that's the green shirt. We do that by adding another modifier. Even we can add another modifier, which the, and we get another phrase, the green shirt. In the earlier example, we have the phrase green shirt, But when once again we add another modification, another modifier, it becomes the phrase the green shirt. When you added the before the green, it became the green shirt. That is the phrase. So what the that word does to the expression green shirt? It is to limit which green shirts could be referred to according to the context. So the is used. The is the modifier which is used before green word in order to have the expression of the green shirt, which is to limit that which green shirts could be referred to according to the context. Thus, in a sequence like the green shirt looked very dirty. Here we have taken here that phrase in the beginning. The green shirt looked very dirty. Here we have the one sentence grammatically, which has meaning. It is meaningful. It has grammar. We can clearly see that the words the and green have more to do with shirt. They are relates more to the word shirt. The green shirt, that more relates. They have more to do with the word shirt than the other words. Which are the other words? Looked dirty or rain. Instead of that, they have to do more to do with the word shirt only. Which are the words? The and green. They have more to do with the shirt than other remaining three words. Looked dirty or rain. Similarly, the word very, it has more to do with dirty because it relates very dirty. So very has more to do with the word dirty than the word looked. So, and another words, the green or shirt. So very is the word which has more to do with the dirty word. In this way, we can see that words are internally organized. In this way, these words are internally organized into smaller group of words, which come together to form a sentence. In this way, when the sentence is formed, before that, there are the group of words that are formed together. You know, smaller groups are there, which are organized, that are formed internally, and that come together in order to form a sentence. These group of words that act like a single unit. These group of words, when they are grouped, that group of words act. How they act? That group of words act like a single unit, which are what we have referred to as phrases. Means when we have the group of words, when we form the group of words, smaller group of words, that's the one kind of a unit of group of words that act like a single unit, that what we have referred to as phrases. In this, it is one kind of the meaning of phrase or phrases. So there are the types or kind of phrases. The type or kind of phrase is determined by which word is considered at the head. How can you point out it's a particular phrase? It depends on. Particularly, it is to be considered as the head word, which is then said to be modified by the other phrase, others in the phrase. For example, the green shirt. Let us discuss, we can think about the example, the green shirt. Here are three words in this group of words. The green shirt. Out of this, which is the head word? Which is the important word here? Here, the shirt is the head word. It is clearly state that shirt, which is the head word, or we can say it is simply the head of this phrase. Since the head of this phrase is a noun, because shirt is the head word, which is a noun. So we can say this is a noun phrase. In short, we can call it as a NP. In this way, we can point out which is the head word and what is the class of that word, that is the particular phrase. See the another example. Similarly, in the another phrase, very dirty. Here, very is the word that modifies dirty, which is therefore is the head of this phrase. Here, dirty is the head of the verb, which is the adjective. So since dirty is the head, which is an adjective, so we can say that this is an adjective phrase. In short, we can say ADJP. So that is the adjective phrase. So other important types of phrases, which include verb phrase, in short, we can say VP. The prepositional phrase, in short, we can say PP. And the adverb phrase, we can say, in short, ADVP. In this way, just like the NP and the ADJP, a phrase is the VP, that is verb phrase, if it is headed by the verb. It is a prepositional phrase. If it is headed by a preposition, and an adverb phrase, if it is headed by an adverb. There are some examples of VP that are walked slowly, ate the breakfast in the morning. Here, slowly we can say that an adverb modifies the meaning of walk. In the second verb phrase, the verb is modified by the two expressions which answer the questions ate what, ate when. In this way, we can say making the meaning of the verb more specific. Here we have seen the meaning of the phrase, the definition of the phrase, what are the types of the